Hi, and welcome to this tutorial about Ontology signature service. My name is Matthias. As usual, we start in the developer center and then we navigate to Pionica Suite. In Pionica Suite, we have the tutorials, and this one is the one called How to Use Ontology Signature Service. Ontology Signature Service is a service to facilitate account management and secure signing of messages. It's very applicable for large enterprise applications or its own standalone microservices. You'll often use it where you need to automate a transaction and host that in a secure environment where you can provide a range of features and functionalities. Some of the things we can do with the signature service is account management. For instance, we can create accounts and we can export accounts. We can also do signing of transactions. First thing we need to do is to install the signature service. We can do it two ways. Either we can download the latest release on GitHub, or we can install it by terminal. For this tutorial, I'm gonna download the latest release from the GitHub. So I'm gonna navigate to GitHub. Then I will find one called tool/windows or -windows.zip. And I'm gonna download it. And now I will extract the file, and I'm gonna extract it to the same place where I have my Ontology node. So in here. And then we can proceed. So next step is to get it started. And you will see some logging and start the service sections here, and I encourage you to read them and try them out. I'm gonna skip them for this tutorial. There's a couple of things we need to do here. First of all, we need to go into the tools that we just downloaded, and we can launch the signature service. And now it's initiated successfully, and here is the IP and the port for the signature service. There's a couple of things we also need to do. First of all, I use a program called Postman to interact with the API, and Postman looks like this. And if you want this particular program, you can just go Google Postman API. And you'll find it. We also need a solo chain, and remember to run it as administrator. And I will just minimize solo chain for the time being. Okay, let's try to set up the Postman. What we need to do here is that we need the IP and the port. Copy that, go into Postman, and it's a post. So we're gonna do like this, and then we're gonna write http://, and also this /CLI. And this is equivalent to writing a localhost, like we see here, localhost. Okay. And then next step is to how to use API methods. And the first method is a create account. So I'll go back to Postman, and I will go to the body, then I'll go to raw, and I will choose JSON. Then I'll go back to the documentation here, and I can take the request example, back to Postman, post it. And we can see for this one, we create an account and we can type in a password, 1234, create account. We're gonna post it to the localhost IP. And then we'll get the result here. So this is the new account that we created. I'm gonna go ahead and save this query. It account. And I'm going to create a folder called signature server and allocate it in there. So now we can see our queries here. Here's the post create account. I'm going to create a new one and copy the IP into that, and it's still the post one. Make sure it's on body, raw, and JSON. Go back to my tutorial here, and then we can proceed to next method, which is export account. And we have the request example here. Gonna go ahead and copy it, paste it in here. So we have the ID, the export account, and parameters, and we're gonna send away the query. This will create a wallet, and we can see the wallet destination is the same as where we placed the signature service. So let's check if it's there. We can see signature service and the wallet that we just created. And again, I can go ahead and I can save this query as export account. And back to the tutorial. So next step is to go into signing. And for this example, I will take the one called sign arbitrary data. And the request example is this one. I'm gonna create a new one. Body, raw, JSON, post, the post query to this IP port. Gonna delete the text here. And then we have to put in an account, which is the first account that we created. Gonna put in the password, 1234. And we have some raw data, which is equivalent to the hello world. And then I will post the query. So based on this, we get the signed data here. Again, I'm gonna save it, call it sign. And then we go back. Okay, going forward, here is the signed raw transaction. You can try that out yourself. And we come to the sign transfer transaction, another method. So this is if we want to assign a transfer from one account to another one. And I'm gonna go ahead and copy the request example here. Again, body, raw, text, JSON, copy paste, post query, copy paste IP and port, and now we will make a transfer. So first we will transfer from this account that we created in the beginning, and the password 1234. That account, and then we will go into our solo chain because the account is still empty. So we can go ahead and make a transfer. We want to transfer some ONGs to that account. We also going to transfer some ONG to that account just to make sure. We can go into our CLI and check it out. So we will cd to documents, ontology. Exit balance, paste the account, and see the funds has been received. And we also need to make sure we transfer to an address. So I'm gonna take this one from my private net in SoloChain, put it in here, and the amount 10 ONG by default. So now we have the transaction here, and I'm gonna send it, and we will receive a signed transaction. So this is the signed one, and now we signed this transaction and we want to push it to the blockchain. So what we can do is that we can copy paste this go back to our CLI, and then we can say ontology dot exe slash help, and see there is a command called send transaction, and we're gonna say ontology exe send transaction. Paste the signed transaction into that. And we're gonna see what's happening. And the transaction has successfully been sent, and here's the transaction ID. Okay, that was more or less it. So please go in and check out the application for the signature service. And as always, go check out our Discord on the Developer Center and catch me in there on FluidDK. I will help you connect with the developers and answer all your questions. Thank you.